pulled this together a few weeks ago at dinner, because they're all kind of sitting around playing, or talking about playing. And then it occurred to us, all these guys play an instrument. And so I'm thinking, hey, let's get to play together. And this is what happened.
One of our young people leads us out in prayer. put, we worship you, we praise you. We thank you for Jesus coming into our lives to save us from our sins and despair. Show others a path to your way. All of us, boys and girls, as well as adults, we all came to turn for you to bless us. Please bless, oh Lord, please bless all of us today. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. Maybe see.
At the cross, where I met my blessed Savior. He suffered, he bled, he hung his head, he died. Just for me, just for you. Today we praise and celebrate him because that is not how the story ends. He lives, he lives. Please remain, please stand for the Great Commission. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen.
Thank you. please come in.
Amen. Did you hear that? It sounds like someone important is coming.
Let's practice what we should do if we see a king or a queen coming.
Boys, you should bow like this. And girls, you should curtsy like this. All right, now let's hear the music again.
Stand up and do it.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do and comfort thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and say all manner of evil against you, falsely, for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted they the prophets which were before me. May the Lord bless the hearers and doers of his word.
Thank you.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they pierced him in the side? Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Do what he has to do for you and for me. we just remember a special guest who came with his family. Jesus took some water.
Yes, plain water.
Blessed it.
And it was the best wine you ever tasted. I will never forget.
We will tell our children. Not only can he change things,
but he can change lives.
I was there.
The last time.
I saw Jesus was at a sermon on a beautiful mountain. So many of us had gathered as he taught us about the blessings we receive when we are pure in heart, when we are peacemakers, and even when we are persecuted for his sake. That was a beautiful day, a day full of hope. Now all I could do is just hold on to these words and pray for those who hated and feared this gentle man.
Thank you.
crucifixion. And on that Calvary Hill, as it was ending, Christ said, "It is finished." Yes. And he died. They wrapped his body. They took him from the cross. They wrapped his body. They placed it in a tomb. And I was reading where it's described that this tomb was large enough, and the rock that had to be placed in front of this tomb was over 2 tons. They had a groove where they would roll the rock in front of the opening to the tomb. And then they sealed it because they wanted to make sure that the disciples couldn't sneak in the middle of the night and steal his body and say he raised from the dead. So they did all these things after the crucifixion to make sure that he stayed in the grave. But Matthew 28, verse 1 said, "Now after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake. For an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back that 2-ton stone. And then what did he do? He sat on it." That nobody can hold back what God says is going to happen. "His countenance was like lightning and his clothing was white as snow. And the guards shook for fear of him and became like dead. But the angel answered and said to the women, 'Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen as he said. Come see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And indeed he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you.'" That's the end of the story. He conquered death. He conquered sin. He did all those things so that we have an opportunity to meet him in heaven. And that opportunity is only available to us if we confess our sins. The sins that he died for, and turn away from them and to seek his face. That opportunity is for me. That opportunity is for you. And this opportunity this morning, as we reflect on this wonderful story, is to give anyone who came here to learn a little bit more about Jesus and his love, who was touched by the story that the young people told about how he was crucified, and who was encouraged by the fact that he did not just die on the cross, he raised again for you and me. Yeah, yeah. So if there's anyone here, we don't want to close the service without an opportunity for someone to come, to give their life to Christ, to come to that Christ who cares so much for you. I don't know what you're struggling with. I don't know what's on your heart. But the God in heaven, Christ who died, can be there for you. I would invite us all to stand as we close and have a word of prayer. We reflect on our life. Reflect on Christ's life and what he did for us. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this message. The message that was brought and depicted as it relates to you coming onto this world to show us an example of how to live dependent upon you. How you were crucified for things that you didn't do. How you were crucified for the sins that I committed. And how you took that burden upon yourself so that I, as long as everyone under the sound of my voice, has that opportunity to be saved. We give you all the praise, honor, and glory. We thank you for rising again and giving us the instructions to become disciples for you, to tell others about this wonderful message, so that this law have an opportunity to be saved. Thank you for that. Thank you for this day. And thank you, dear Lord, for these young people who are hearing and seeing and doing your work. Christ Jesus' name.
Storehouse, for us, I must that we will not have room enough to receive as we await your return.